Well, we're here today at Tawonga South and Mount Beauty, which is behind me, conducting a planned burn on the Tawonga Gap Road. The burn is 660 hectares in size, and it's bordered by another burn we intend to conduct tomorrow, which is approximately 1,000 hectares. The burning here at Tawonga South and Mount Beauty, is to ensure that we get appropriate fuel management to the west and to the northwest of these communities to provide bushfire protection in the case of future bushfires. This area has experienced severe bushfires in 2006 with the Tawonga Gap fire, and community really want to see active fuel management going forward to the west and to the northwest of their communities for further protection.
There's sort of a gully between O and P. Do you want the sort of north side of that treated or just stay to the south of it?
Oh, Ferrari ignition will stay south of the gully, but you will see some hand ignition along the bitumen.
We've been pushing for this burn for probably the last couple of years, and we're very happy to see that it's finally taken place. It makes the whole of this area a lot easier to protect in the case of we had a wildfire. We got a very good relationship with DELWP. We help them out whenever we can, because whatever they do helps us along the way, and we try and help them as much as we can.
Today the burn incorporates the Tawonga Gap Road. We've got a high voltage power line with AusNet services. We've got local government with Tawonga residents and Tawonga South, Mount Beauty. So there's a number of stakeholders that we've had to engage in the planning for this burn and in the preparation. Assisting in delivering the burn today, we have the CFA, Parks Victoria, as well as Forest Fire Management firefighters. Working through the fire operations planning process, this burn was nominated approximately three years ago. The neighbouring burn, Pub Spur burn for Tawonga, was nominated this year based on advice from local residents and CFA members who wanted to see active fuel management to the west and northwest of their community. So we were able to do a late nomination and were able to deliver that burn in this financial year along with the Tawonga Gap Ryders Spur burn. So essentially the Tawonga South and Mount Beauty residents are going to see really good protection out of these two planned burns, you know, for the next 3 to 5 years from any bushfire.
In conjunction with the private landholders, we've been able to burn, make the burn more accessible through private property, and so in return it makes the risk to the local area much less.
So delivering these two burns in the Upper Kiwa Valley in conjunction with the CFA is really a prime example of how DELWP, Parks Victoria and the CFA are working together to protect Victorian communities.